Hey guys, Dr. Ahmad Al-Hassiny here from the Institute of Digital Dentistry. And today, let's go over a full review of the PANDA Smart Intraoral Scanner. In this video, I wanted to cover some of the pros and the cons and some really interesting stuff that the company is doing with AI. Let's get into it. Okay, so this is the PANDA Smart Intraoral Scanner, which I've been using in my clinic for close to 6 months now, for basically all indications, simple crown and bridge, scanning edentulous, scanning for implants, etc. And over that period, I've had a lot of time to reflect about how the scanner competes in this market compared to all other intraoral scanners, but also had the opportunity to watch the software develop, because the company behind this scanner has put a lot of effort into the software. I've already released an unboxing video about the scanner with all the key details. So if you haven't watched that, I would recommend you check that out first. But for this video, rather than go over all the specifications, I wanted to share some of the pros and cons of this scanner that I've noticed during clinical use. So for starters, what are some of the good things about the PANDA Smart Intraoral Scanner? Well, the most obvious thing is the size and weight of this thing. It weighs 138 grams, making it the lightest intraoral scanner that is currently and actively being sold in this market, with the only thing close to it being the new Medit i900 at 165 grams, but that is a much bigger scanner overall. Because the thing is, the PANDA Smart is not just lightweight, but it's really tiny. It's really like the size of a toothbrush or something. And I think if 10 years ago, people theorized the future of intraoral scanning, I'm sure they would have imagined something as small as this, because it really is quite frankly amazing and a testament to how far the technology has come. The other good thing is the build quality. The PANDA Smart Intraoral Scanner is made out of metal, which is a rarity in this market, which actually gives it quite decent build quality, although the scanner heads are still a bit of a cheap plastic, but that's forgivable. It also comes in 6 different colors, which is a neat addition. Apart from colors, what I also liked in day-to-day use is the simple USB 3.0 connection, not even USB-C. No power cables or anything like that. Simply plug it in and you're ready to scan within minutes. Now, for scanning, overall, it does a decent job. In saying that, the 2024 scanner market is totally different to even 5 years ago. Almost any scanner can scan fast these days, and that includes the PANDA Smart. Using this scanner, I could scan full arches, including the palate, in around 30, 45 seconds, sometimes 60 seconds if it was a quite hard arch, or thereabouts. So it does have decent scan speeds. Lastly, the cost of the scanner could also be seen as a positive. It is $12,800. In saying that, this could also be seen as a bit of a con, as this puts it in the price bracket of some heavy hitters in the market, like the Medit i600 and the newly released Trios Core. So that is some of the pros of this scanner. What about the cons? Well, for starters, the software. Now, in saying that, over the past 6 months, I have watched the software totally get developed. PANDA now has an iPhone app with cloud features and a separate patient management software, which are all pretty decent. Not mind-blowingly good, but decent. The software that I thought could use an improvement badly is the scanning software itself. It is similar to the older generation software, and in my opinion, it just looks quite dated. Also, the scan resolution is just not the highest, and you can see this when you zoom up into the scans, as they just don't look that detailed, a bit pixelated. Although that doesn't mean they're not accurate, which I tested in many iDD compares posts, and you can check them out on the iDD blog. So scanning resolution is one thing. I also found the software very occasionally, but notably, puts the wrong texture on the teeth. Sometimes the gingival color texture would ride up on the teeth margins, which I found a little strange in today's market. The handy thing about the software, though, is that it can be improved. So without a doubt, the PANDA team, or Frecti Technology, could improve these features. And for them and for the team, I would put them as a high priority. The other thing I did notice is that the very small size of the scanner almost is a double-edged sword. And what I mean by this is that in the scanner market, we are seeing more and more scanners go for larger capture field of views. Think about the ITER Illumina, the Meta i900, etc. A larger field of view makes scanning arguably faster, as you can capture more in the same time. But with the PANDA, the tiny body means that the scanner field of view is also relatively small, at 18 by 16 millimeters, with a respectable scan depth of 20 millimeters, however. Basically, the scanner reminded me a lot of the Omnicam scan head. The days of tiny intraoral scanners with tiny scan heads, and frankly, I find them to be a little bit more technique sensitive, because if you move too fast or abruptly, they can lose their track. However, with good scan strategy and scanning techniques, once again, this is a fast scanner. So that is the PANDA Smart. One of the things I did want to mention, and to me was the most interesting factor about this scanner, is what the company is doing with their software. The iOS market is saturated with scanners, and I have said it time and time again. Yes, low cost is one of the main buying factors, but with so many low cost scanners these days, softwares and workflows is what is differentiating scanners. And the PANDA team have done some pretty cool stuff that I feel like needs to be mentioned. For starters, their software is called PANDA Center, which is their patient and scanner management software. Something that I see that is really popular with Chinese scanners is this user interface that shows you a preview of all the scans in a thumbnail in the patient list, and you can find it here too. More interestingly though, is that PANDA have a cloud that is totally free. You can send scans to the cloud and then access them on an iPhone app called PANDA Union. This iPhone app immediately syncs with any scans that you've sent to the cloud and has a totally 3D viewer on the app, which honestly is quite amazing for a low-cost scanner product, and it is a true cloud feature. The other interesting thing is that the app has an AI smile design feature. You can literally take a single picture of a smiling patient or upload a picture of a patient, and within 2 to 3 minutes, the iPhone app uses AI to mark the lip line and create a 2D smile design, which looks quite decent, surprisingly. So with one picture and one click, you get a smile design with decent textures and overall something that can actually be shown to patients. Not like those cartoony appearances that you can often get with other smile design software and look a bit ugly. The smile design app in the PANDA software takes it further and generates a short video simulating speaking and smiling, which is kind of crazy. It's quite cool and caught me off guard, frankly, because although it is a little uncanny and I'm not sure what patients would think of it, as from a single photo, you get a moving video. Another thing PANDA offers for free is an orthodontic simulator, which frankly is okay at best, not really that amazing, and we've seen this sort of free software by Medit, for example, and I find the PANDA version to be rudimentary, frankly, and it needs improvement, but in saying that, it's a free software, and no doubt, again, with software, it can be updated and improved. Lastly, PANDA also have a CAD software capable of generating single unit designs, and I can't think of any other scanner apart from, again, Medit, that offers a CAD software for free. Once again, however, the PANDA version is very rudimentary, and I mean super basic. The tools are simple, the AI works okay-ish at the best of times, and it's not really something I would say I recommend as CAD for beginners, but it's free once again, and it's there. The company has developed it. They put resources into it, so kudos to them. Also, this could potentially be improved. So once again, free software that companies are offering their customers. So that is basically it for the Panda Smart. Overall, a cool product, especially the form factor, the lightweightness, and what the company could achieve cramming all this technology in this tiny body. For me, it is a scanner that could be improved, and I genuinely hope to see it improve, especially on the software side, because at a price of 12,800 USD, it may face some really stiff competition from current market leaders, which seem to be lowering their prices. That's not to say this doesn't have a place in the market. So that's everything, guys, for this IDD review of the Panda Smart. I hope you enjoyed this video. And to read a full written review on this scanner, check out instituteofdigitaldentistry.com. Thanks for watching.